Hello everyone, I'm Melissa Ryerson with the City of Franklin, and this is Kurt Edelman. He's the fire inspector for the Franklin Fire Department. We're in a rough build, new construction home here in Stream Valley, and we're going to talk about how fire sprinklers work and what they look like in the rough build, because some homeowners don't get a chance to walk through. They might have the drywall already up. So right here is the whole entertainment center, so to speak. You call it the riser. This one right. Happens to be in a closet. Sometimes they're in garages or other places. Talk about what this is.
Okay, EPEX piping down here, this is the water service coming into the home. Okay, and we have an on-off valve here to shut the water on and off. And then this first T coming off of the riser, this is the water to the domestic service, your toilets, your sinks, your bathtub, your washer, and all of that. And then the riser continues up to the sprinkler system. Now the first part of the sprinkler system is a one-way valve or a check valve. And what this valve does is it keeps the water in the sprinkler system from coming down and mixing with the domestic water. Now, one of the things about a residential sprinkler is that it's all plastic pipe. There's really no problems with corrosions or anything like that. But still, it's desirable not to have the water in the sprinkler system mixing with the water in the domestic system. So we put this check valve in here. Going up the riser, this is a flow switch so that if water starts to flow within the sprinkler system, this flow switch would activate and it will either turn a bell on the outside of the house or turn on a horn strobe to let the homeowner and let other people surrounding the home to know that there's water flowing in the sprinkler system. And then the next T coming off of the riser, this is a drain. And this is like, for example, if you want to do work on your system or you wanted to drain your system for one reason or another, this is a drain. It's not attached yet, but the builder will put a fitting on here that attaches to a garden hose, and you just took your garden hose up to that and run the garden hose outside, and you can drain your sprinkler system. Also, this is the valve that you would use if you wanted to test your system.
Okay.
And then finally up here, this is a gauge. It tells what the pressure is in the system when the system isn't running. And then if the system should run, then the gauge pressure will drop a little bit, and you know that the water's running.
Now this is going up into the second floor, but on the first floor most of the pipes will be in the ceiling, correct? And then on the second floor they may be in some of the walls, interior walls.
Right. Generally what we have, they call it a tree system. It's set up like a tree. You know, we have a trunk coming up and then it branches all out. To increase the efficiency of the sprinkler system, they loop it together. There are loops so that each sprinkler generally gets water from two directions, and that maximizes the water flow, because what we're looking for is about 20 gallons per minute from one head, or two heads we're looking for 13 gallons per minute each. And like you mentioned, up on the second floor, because we have pipe going from the first floor up to the attic space, there is pipe running in the walls, and you just need to be aware of that. Now, the sprinkler installer will install plates over the studs where the sprinkler riser is coming through. So if you're drilling and all of a sudden you meet resistance, you want to stop drilling.
There's different types, some that come out of the ceiling and some that come out of the wall, right?
Right. This is a residential home, and generally we'll have two types of sprinklers in here. We'll have pendant sprinklers, which come like a pendant, they hang down from the ceiling, and then we have a sidewall which comes straight out. Usually the sidewall is used for areas that like with a peaked roof or something like that. Like a lot of people have those in their breakfast areas and things like that. The sidewall head you will always see, but the pendant heads, what they'll do is they'll have a cap that they put on the sprinkler, and they won't put this on until the final stage of construction, but they put this over the sprinkler, and then it gives the ceiling a smooth look.
But flush mount.
But one thing you need to be careful of is that they come in white, and that's the color you need to leave them. You're not permitted to paint them, because what this plate has is it has these little solder points in it, and these solder points melt at like about 150 degrees or so. And then that's what enables the cap to fall off, and then the sprinkler will start to activate at about 155 degrees. But if you paint it or something, it's going to insulate that, and it's not going to be able to detach as quickly. If you want to specific color. You can order them from the factory. It is a little bit pricey, but you know, if you want to do it, there certainly are available, and they'll make them in just about any color you want.
All right. Thanks, Kurt. Good information to know.
All right. Thank you.